Can the power of music fight a version of Vecna in real life, just as it does in Stranger Things? Welcome to Science Blast, where we quickly explain the interesting areas where pop culture meets real science. In the first part of season 4 of Netflix's wildly popular science fiction horror series, Stranger Things, music plays a critical role to the plot and how it is able to counteract the dark forces of the upside down. To get into how and how this could potentially apply to you in real life, I'm going to go into some events revealed up to episode 4 of season 4. So if you haven't caught up to that, this is your spoiler alert. When part 1 of season 4 first released, you likely noticed the song Running Up That Hill by Kate Bush, one of my favorite artists, by the way, trending because of how it factors into a truly powerful moment of the show, in which the character of Max Mayfield, played by Sadie Sink, is able to be pulled from the clutches of the monster called Vecna at the last second, through the way her favorite song is able to reach her mind in ways unmatched by words or other stimuli. There is, in many ways, a real-world parallel to Vecna, who, like the other antagonists of Stranger Things, gets his name from Dungeons & Dragons, where he is an undead lich, a master of necrosis and living death. And his spell, a condition in which people are sometimes said to be locked into the recesses of their mind, experiencing times and places not representative of reality, and facing fear and confusion as a result. And like Vecna's trance, is fatal. This condition, of course, is Alzheimer's, a leading cause of death and disease estimated to impact over 6 million people in the US alone, and tens of millions more worldwide. And, much like the trance that the characters in Stranger Things experience, one of the only tools that provides some relief is music, specifically music that has made an impact on that person in the past. In 2013, researchers at the University of Salamanca in Spain conducted an experiment in which one set of Alzheimer's patients were stimulated with familiar music and another set stimulated with unfamiliar music. The results were striking. According to Scientific American, those who heard tunes they knew showed an immediate improvement in identity, mood, moral judgment, and body awareness, elements of self-consciousness that are adversely affected by Alzheimer's. Those who listened to unfamiliar music scored worse on all measures except body awareness. The researchers also administered a common exam for dementia to test the patient's overall cognition. The group who heard familiar music sustained their scores over time, whereas the group who listened to unfamiliar music faltered significantly. You may have actually seen this related and incredible video from the documentary film Alive Inside, which shows the impact music can have on those losing their hold on reality. After visiting Victor Creel in Penhurst Asylum, Nancy and Robin actually describe what may be happening here quite well.
Hatch said that music can reach parts of the brain that words can't, so maybe that's the key, a lifeline
back to reality.
Just as music in the show connects Max to her memories, and that is what grants her temporary reprieve, that is precisely the effect that music can have on those suffering with dementia, which, like many, has affected my own loved ones. For me, it was my grandmother. And in the rare times when she could form complete sentences, I distinctly remember her saying sometimes, "I'm still me inside, but I just can't get out." I wish I would have known back then the power that familiar music had to potentially help her, like Max.
I'm still here.
But it's important to note that by the end of episode 4, the threat of Vecna has still not been eliminated. And it's the same with Alzheimer's. In real life, Kate Bush, as magical as she definitely is, cannot defeat this evil alone. Only delay it. And you can actually help. By supporting charities working on therapies to truly overcome Vecna's curse for good. And there is some good news. Promising research demonstrating that not just music, but lights, sounds, and other safe and cheap stimuli in the right combinations could be used to combat dementia like Alzheimer's, and perhaps even reverse it. In a way, Vecna is real, and you can fight him, just like a lot of us did when we were kids. If you have someone you care for suffering from these terrible maladies, play them a song they love. And if you can, support charities like ours at lifespan.io. that are working on exactly these sorts of stimulus-based therapies and technologies that could one day overcome such diseases. We're all running up that hill together as we're waiting for season 4, part 2. And together, we could potentially throw Vecna down it for good. No problem. Hey everyone, thanks for watching this video. As you could probably tell, this was a personal one for me, and I hope you enjoyed it. Please like and share, and let me know in the comments your thoughts. Or if you've had any positive experiences with music, or any other stimuli seemingly helping with dementia or Alzheimer's disease, it could help our work. Thank you, and see you next time on Science to Save the World.